we're all very excited to be underway, and we've been chatting to the team that's down at Davis Station. They've been there for 12 months now, and they're pretty excited for us to turn up in a couple of weeks' time and resupply the station and bring them home again. Oh, about 35 tonnes of that cargo will be food for Davis Station for the year. In addition to that, we'll have 850,000 litres of special Antarctic blend diesel, which keeps the station powered and all their vehicles running for the year ahead.
Davis Station doesn't have a fresh water source, so we need to produce fresh water using salt water via a desalination plant and then store that water for most of the year actually, until we can produce water again in a small window during summer. So we're working on a reverse osmosis desalination plant, a new building which will replace the existing building which is now at its end of life.
They'll be undertaking seabird monitoring programs, including participating in our long-term penguin and flying seabird monitoring programs, and also looking for any signs of avian influenza around our stations. We've also got a team that will be heading down to do some environmental monitoring, and particularly looking at some of the legacy waste at Mawson Station, gathering information that will help us to build a program to clean up that area.
The great thing about this voyage to Davis is you're getting to take a whole bunch of expeditioners down to Antarctica, and we've got a lot of people that haven't been south before. So seeing their excitement as you come through those icebergs, through the pack ice and then arriving at Davis, it's a great journey and it's a real privilege to be a part of people's Antarctic expeditions.